Alright. My eye a second. Take point.
Let's go.
Counting on you to do good.
Careful. Okay. Let's go.
Yeah, I see a weapon over there. I'm gonna go get it. You guys do your thing. Covering fire.
Over there.
Can't say I'm not helping now. Well, we're not stealthing though. Let me switch over to the other sniper.
Let's go.
Machine pistol, eh? Here. You'll be backed up, don't worry. Holy crap, Jesus. There's only so much I can do, though.
Cover!
Oh my god, how am I pushing through this? Naturally, snakes stress to hell at this point. Oh, now you guys have a bulldozer to help. Thanks.
The rebels have got an armored dozer. They're probably going to use it to bust their way into the mansion. Give it some cover and it might get you inside the compound.
Oh, great. So this is basically just a combat segment. All right. With all the cover I gave it. Almost there, though. Fire. Oh boy, I'm stressed.
My back?
Yeah, come on, let's go.
Advance! Cover!
Hopefully not what I meant to do.
Fire! Fire!
Right. Hey. Jesus. Oh, shit. Well, that was lucky.
Suppressing fire.
Let's find a spot I can get. Get over here. Can I get out through here? No, okay. I am extremely stressed. I'm gonna eat some noodles to help with that.
It's the enemy.
Oh, where'd you come from? What? Oh, am I in their spawn spot? I swear to God, he just popped out of nowhere on my radar. I swear to God. Munya? Hey, that sounds pretty cool, actually. All I gotta do is equip it. Yeah, look at it fighting the stress. It ain't perfect, but it works when you're under stress. Alright, cool. Still gotta find a spot I can get out of here, because my destination's on the other side of this wall.
Go, go,
Nobody needs backup. Oh, you're a rebel. Okay, I didn't see you were a rebel. I thought you were an enemy. My bad.
Back me up.
Shit. Don't bump into me.
Cover.
Fire. Peek-a-boo. I helped. Love to help you do, but I have to go in the other direction, so. Yeah, dude, there's hostiles everywhere. There was no need to point me out. Specifically, holy shit. Okay, well. I'm well past it. I gotta go back the other way. Damn. Alright. The Otacon.
The lab where they're making Naomi do her research is somewhere inside. First things first, find a way to get inside that mansion. The rebels have pushed their way inside. This is the PMC's last stronghold. They'll stop at nothing to defend it. This battle's only gonna get bloodier from here.
The bloodier, the better. For me, at least.
That's only if you make use of the situation. Be ready for anything.
Maybe I am supposed to go inside this building. Case, we need to go back.
We've got company.
Back me up. Fire.
Well, I'm in. Now I match the decor, so that's good. Ooh, Pentasmin? Hell yeah. Take that. Well.
Oh,
that's outside. I won't go outside. Hi. Yeah, there should be guys in here, huh?
Yeah.
Alright, you know what?
Understood. Stand by. Sending reinforcements now.
Carpet real quick. Looks like he's going away. All right. Don't tell me, dude, just spawned right there. Okay, no.
We got company.
All right. All right, Otacon. Let's see what you can do. Yeah, no, it's a bust. I mean, it's a nice place, but ain't nothing I need in here. Should be, yeah. Well, that didn't turn up anything useful, so back to the question of how the fuck am I getting past this wall? There's probably something like really obvious that I'm just missing, right? Wait a minute, hey! I thought this was gonna drop me somewhere I've already been in, but... Oh, this was past the blocked door! Oh, I am dumb, okay. Alright. Looks like it's only rats in here, so we should be alright. Claymore. Alright, this should be where we need to be. Perfect, okay. Alright. I guess I just didn't explore the mansion thoroughly enough. Fair enough. Still with a dream, snake eater. Okay, there we go. Made it. Well, this is a nice place. A sneaking action. So hard to hear the voices during these scenes.
I know. Me too.
Snake, focus. Snake, focus. Her face is up top. And she did that herself to herself before too.
Naomi.
Snake.
Naomi, you would not believe how many people I had to kill to get here. If I just could not figure this out.
Seen you since Shadow Moses. How long? 10 years?
9.
And Dr. Emmerich, is he with you?
In spirit.
I thought he'd be the only one able to open the mail I sent. Not many people could recognize 4D sound data in a Soliton radar file. How is the good doctor?
Monocon's fine. He's the same as ever.
Still single, still sad.
I
mean, sad isn't, like, kind of pathetic.
Who were you just talking to?
Shit.
Liquid. Although I suppose he's really...
Octopus is outside.
From a medical standpoint.
I thought he was here.
Shit.
He's not. At the moment.
Where are all the guards?
Look, Naomi, some bad stuff's about to go down.
They know I won't escape. I'm powerless to resist. I have no choice but to cooperate.
Naomi, what happened in the Middle East?
It's Liquid's own fox eye, right?
Soldiers' emotions run amok.
Another product of the system.
Don't trust me?
I'm not sure yet.
And if I answer,
I mean, you did try to kill me.
Let's hear it first.
Liquid. We thought the SOP was an ID control system designed primarily to maintain order and control in battle. And we were right. SOP had another function. To control people's senses. The nanomachines inside soldiers' bodies adapt to different conditions, promoting the release of neurotransmitters, hormones, and stimulants, giving them an edge in battle. They can create an artificial combat high by releasing endorphins at the same time a soldier kills an enemy. Or they can suppress hormones to neutralize the soldier's emotions, prevent them from panicking and engaging in friendly fire or needless massacres. It's all controlled by the system's core AI. It artificially controls the soldier's pain, emotions, senses, in other words, the essence of his being. The skyrocketing demands of the war economy have fueled the demand for more soldiers and more fighting. This in turn...
Dang, injection of nanomachines is cheaper than building whole androids, though. Okay.
...and control their actions. The system ensures a steady supply of battle-optimized soldiers at a minimum of cost. But you, of all people, must understand, Snake, that unlike combat technique, a soldier's senses can't be taught. They must be earned through experience.
Does this have something to do with that test of yours?
The goal was to release the soldier's nanomachines from the system. But we didn't know about the mental control.
And the nanomachines went berserk?
No. Our test was a success. At least it confirmed our hypothesis at the time. Just as we predicted, the nanomachines stopped functioning, and the PMC soldiers were freed from the grips of the system. But the moment the system stopped, all the pain and fury and sorrow, all the trauma and stress, all the hatred, regret, guilt, all the sensations that had been suppressed were unleashed within their hearts. Their memories, unlike their senses, weren't erased. Each enemy soldier they'd killed, each lost comrade, each threat of violence against the innocent, every act of war they'd committed was etched firmly in their hearts. In suppressing the user's mind, the nanomachines exact a heavy burden on his heart. The user's body rejects the nanomachines. This reaction must then be suppressed with drugs. Before the user knows it, his mind is in complete shambles. Snake, remember Frank?
Frank Yeager. Gray Fox.
They twisted his body for their experiments and nullified his broken heart with nanomachines.
Yeah, and he was kind of cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs towards the end.
Hurt me more.
The battlefield hasn't. Until that point, war was like a game to them.
Duh.
Suddenly, reality came crashing down.
Under construction. you cheeky little buggers.
Ordinarily, our hearts are hardened through experience. Even the most grizzled veterans live with an inescapable guilt they've had to overcome bit by bit through the years. And even then, it never truly goes away.
Oh, shit.
For a mind lacking that essential experience, it was simply too much to bear.
Snake, are you trying to get a peek?
But what about me? I've never been under the system's control.
So that's what you think.
That's why I want to examine your body. You need to know.
Or maybe you have, I don't know.
All right, Snake. Undress.
I don't know if this is the time for that, but...
What's gotten into you? Hurry up.
Yeah, no, this ain't gonna end well. Kinda don't want to take off my armor just before... Yeah, I'm an old man, I know.
All right, let's just get this over with.
Yes. Of course. I'm sorry. Snake, do you remember what I told you in my video mail about the first generation of nanomachines?
The ones you stuck me with at Motus.
Yes. The nanomachines are recharged by your body heat. They won't stop functioning until they're all extracted. Or until you do. Most of them were lost through bleeding and excretion, but around 30% still remain inside your body, attached to your cells. The first generation were never ID registered, so they don't react in the same way as the SOP nanomachines. But they may be interfering with your body and with your heart.
So, does the aging have something to do with Fox diet too?
No. Your telomeres were intentionally set up to be short, regardless of the age of the original. One of the genes that inhibit reproduction and aging, the Clotho gene, was intentionally mutated as well. More importantly, your chromosomes, like liquids, were provided with terminator genes to prevent them from making copies.
Why?
Your clones created for one purpose, war. And so, in order to prevent you from being abused by clients or stolen by the enemy, they shortened your lifespan and removed your ability to reproduce. It was a safety device to ensure that the seed of Big Boss didn't end up in the hands of others. The reason you're aging so rapidly isn't because of disease, faulty research, or Fox dye. It's how you were born. It's your natural lifespan.
Great.